इत्तेहाद न्यूज़ को देखने से पहले सब्सक्राइब कीजिए हमारे चैनल को, लाइक कीजिए और बेल आइकॉन पर क्लिक कीजिएगा।
So let me now come to two other or two or three other topics which I just want to touch because I have only 25 minutes and I'll finish within that time. So the finance minister very well knows that there is a ministry's report, Reserve Bank of India's report of July 2020, because the finance minister has suggested that all the NPAs, and the NPAs are now are snowballing. All the NPAs will be transferred to a new asset reconstruction company. And they will then be managed by an asset management company. And then the scheme seems to be, because the details of the scheme are not with us, but broadly, what you say is that the net worth of an NPA will be determined after minusing the provisioning in the bank accounts, in the accounts of the bank. And that of that net worth, say that net worth comes to 100 crores. Just give an example. 15% will be paid in cash to the bank. And the balance, 85%, will be a sort of a haircut for the bank. Right? And then security receipts will be given to this asset reconstruction company. And through that, those security receipts, the value of the asset will be realized. This is the scheme that you have adopted. Now, we don't know at what stage the 15% cash is to be given. Nobody knows. And from where? From which account? And all this will be managed by the public sector banks who were actually mismanaged earlier and brought the NPAs to this high level. This will all be managed by the public sector banks. So I'm asking you, where will you get, how will you give that 15%? When will you give that 15%? How will you calculate who is to give? Secondly, what will happen to that security receipt? Are you going to sell that asset? How are you going to sell that asset? You can't go back to the IBC process. If you go back to the IBC process, it will land in the same fashion. So will you do it through private negotiations like you have done in the past? And you know who will buy it in those private negotiations? And I'm surprised that the budget papers do not reflect the manner in which you're going to dispose this off, how it is going to be done. And you're leaving it to later time. I thought that an important proposal like this should be so transparent that all of us could have looked at it and debated it. But this is all non-transparent. Now, just to tell you, the financial stability report of July 2020 talks of the NPAs of the public sector bank. This is July 2020. And real estate, and it says, share of good quality loans of the industry as share of total good quality loans as on March 2020. Now, the share of good quality loans in the real estate sector is 2.3%. In other words, the bad quality loan is 98.7%. Sorry, 97.7%. Collection and distribution of electricity. Good quality loans is 2.5%. Bad quality is 97.5%. Public utility services, I can go on with these figures, yeah. I don't want
to. Please conclude now, your time is over.
No, sir, my time is not over. No, it's not over yet, I've got 2-4 minutes. Give me another
You have 25 minutes.
Give me another 5 minutes, I'll finish.
You conclude as early as possible.
Your
time is over.
I will conclude before 2:30. Right?
I'm giving you another two, three minutes, but...
No, I'll completed. Conclude before 2:30. I started after 12 o'clock.
1:30. You started at 1:50.
Oh, we are just wasting a minute's time.
Please carry on.
Now, the point is, if this is the state of the NPAs, there is a latest report of the Reserve Bank of India of January 2021. And that latest report, and I quote what it says, is macro stress assets for credit risk show that SCB's GNPA ratio may increase from 7.5% in September 2020 to 13.5% by September 2021. Under the baseline scenario, in the macroeconomic environment deteriorates, if the macroeconomic environment deteriorates, the ratio may escalate to 14.8% under the severe stress scenario. These projections are indicative of the possible economic impairment latent in bank portfolios. 14.8%. Now, if that's the state of the economy and that's the state of the NPAs in the bank and that's the state of the banks, even if you transfer the bad loans of 2.1 lakh crores, which you intend to do, to another, to an ARC, these bad assets will continue. These NPAs will continue. They're not going to stop. Now, what you want to do, actually, you want to sell and monetize all the assets in this country. Award private trade bids for completion by May 2021. You're going to sell Kolkata Metro, Concon Rail, track and overhead equipment, redevelopment of railway colonies, railway hospitals. You're going to sell 10,000 crores power transmission assets.
Please conclude now. Please conclude.
No, sir. I've got a few.
No. Your time is over. I have the watch. You know. You ask your chief, please.
2 minutes. Okay. So you're going to privatize that. And who are you going to give it to? Now, sir, I just want to say just one last thing and give me 2 minutes for it, and then I have done.
You have other speakers also.
ये जो दो चार लोगों की मैं जो बात कर रहा हूँ ना, एक ऐसी कंपनी है जिसने जिसके पास लगभग सब कुछ है, पोर्ट्स हैं, एयरपोर्ट्स हैं, सब कुछ है. तो और देखिए, स्टील सेक्टर में दो तीन प्लेयर हैं, पावर सेक्टर में दो तीन प्लेयर हैं, एक प्लेयर सब सेक्टर में है. तो ये कैसे काम चलेगा? दिस इज अ क्लासिक केस ऑफ क्रोनी कैपिटलिज्म. और आखिरी बात जो मैं कहना चाहता हूं वो ये है कि आपने ये बात कही है कि हम पुराने बजट्स में वोट बैंक पॉलिटिक्स करते थे. ये आपने कही, आपके प्रधानमंत्री जी ने कही. और इस बजट में आपने क्या किया? आपने असम में, ये सब जो राज्य सरकारें हैं, यहां चुनाव आने वाले हैं, असम में 34,000 करोड़.
प्लीज
कंक्लूड. आई एम जस्ट कंक्लूडिंग इन अ मिनट. वेस्ट बंगाल में ये बात तो करने दो. वेस्ट बंगाल में 675 असम, वेस्ट बंगाल में 675 किलोमीटर्स बना रहे हैं आप. केरला में 1100 किलोमीटर नेशनल हाईवे, तमिलनाडु में 3500. और आप कहते हैं आप वोट बैंक पॉलिटिक्स नहीं करते. आप बजट में वोट बैंक पॉलिटिक्स करते हो और ऑफ बजट नोट बैंक पॉलिटिक्स करते हो.